Hello everyone. Thank you for joining us at the Insta Live session of IGI today. I'm Natasha Bafna and I'm going to introduce a very popular jewelry designer, Ms. Akansha Chaudhary, and she has a popular jewelry brand called Naira. So without wasting much time, let me just connect with her. Hi Naira. Hi Akansha.
Hi Natasha, how are you?
Good, how are you? Can you hear me very clearly?
Yes, I can hear you clearly.
Okay, I hope you're doing fine and stay safe. Akansha, please tell us about your journey into this field, your technical education, and why did you choose to, come into this industry?
So for me, it went a little bit in reverse. Usually how people, they come forward, they get a formal education and then they start a business. So for me, reverse. I actually had my own business running and I remember that I had gone for an academy. So I said for me, worked very much in reverse. So I had a business into jewelry already. And I remember I was doing it for almost about, 1.5 years. And I remember this one particular incident where I was in Dubai for an exhibition. And there was this lady who walked up to me and she wanted to shop something from my booth. And she asked me that, what is this made of? And at that point in time, I did not know the answer to that question. I kind of have a basic idea, but you can't lie. You never lie to your customers if you don't know the
definitely
answer.
Definitely not, yes.
So I said, ma'am, I'm sorry, but if you're asking me the technical specifications, I'm not aware of it. I would like to humbly accept that. So, to my advantage, she appreciated the honesty. She went ahead and purchased it anyway. But that made me realize that, I was merely trading. Even if I had a knack for designing, I did not know the technical know-how. Like from an idea into my head to a translated final piece of jewelry, I did not know the process that went into it. So for me, it was more about learning what I'm doing. Like it's very important, I feel, to know the technical background. The detailing of what goes into what you're bringing on table for the other. So that's my journey. Like, that's my inquisitive side that led me to pursue the course and understand what I'm doing.
Yes, very important, as a designer to have like a good knowledge. Your base has to be strong so that you continue in this field without any, doubts and you can answer questions very easily.
All right.
Moving forward, I have another question for you. What are the major challenges you have faced in the transition from brick and mortar to an online store?
Many, many. So I think for me, even though Naira started as an online label, but we started expanding our presence very strongly offline. We used to do a lot of exhibitions. Then we opened up a store in Delhi, we opened up a store in Mumbai in India. So, and we started exporting into bridal jewelry. So for us, it was all about touch and feel. Brides would like to come, they would like to try things on. They would like to get a look and feel of what they're going to be wearing. So thanks to the pandemic now, all of the trends have changed. We've had to do social distancing. We've discontinued rental jewelry. There have been a lot of changes that have happened in terms of, so one challenge at the top of my head, I feel is to bring the same experience to the client digitally. What you can, how you can convince them in person, how you can try things for them, you can show it to them, drape it with different attires. That was a very, very challenging part that I think being a startup we're still struggling with because we do not have the bandwidth to get those fancy softwares on board. So with the limited capacity and scope that we have, how do we reach into the customer's house and yet make them feel, not secluded? Yeah. So that's one of the
things. For them, very important, now because of the current scenario, having the online platform is really essential. I totally agree to that.
Absolutely.
All right. How do you think customers who are used to the physical store visit would react to this online platform? Would they easily accept it?
I think yes. Because what happens is, I feel when you are the only one who's doing something, it's very difficult to adapt. But when you understand that that's the norm now, you kind of get used to it. So, there are a few brides. I think my brides in India are now shopping with me how my brides overseas shop. you know, our overseas brides, they take appointments with us and we have a dedicated member who sits and who wears jewelry for them, who tries to show it to them with different outfits and colors and everything. So I think brides in India are now kind of shifting to that trend. They're getting used to the whole digital environment, you know, going online, shopping on a click of it. So I think it's going to take a while, but with the millennial brides or the millennial shoppers, jewelry lovers, how we say, they're pretty much taking it relatively easier than I thought.
Nice. I'm sure this will really help you to tap international customers as well through internet, through online platforms.
A lot more, because a lot of these Indian brides, you know, they would want to do like one quick trip back home in India to do their wedding shopping. But now you can't do that. So now it's like, you know, just online Zoom call interviews and conferences and appointments, and you sit with the entire family, you wear jewelry for them, you put different rates and show them how this is going to go with this. So yeah, I think it's a fun change. It's a very substantial change, but it's good. I mean, we're liking
it. Yeah, eventually so people, I think, will get used to this. That's nice.
Yeah.
All right. Akanksha, your brand focuses a lot on wedding bridal jewelry. Skinny jewelry is in vogue right now. So what are the major observations that you have made about the perception of bridal jewelry?
The perception has changed very significantly, I feel. You know, we, when we're talking about bridal jewelry, it's safe to say we're talking about the Indian, you know, big ostentatious, the big hula wedding that happens. Yeah. I think now what's happening is the wedding sizes have gone up to almost 140. You know, you had 200 people, now you're taking barely like 40, 80, 60, 80 people in your wedding. So brides are now focusing on very niche designer wear pieces, like, which is, you know, like more eye for detailing and quality versus the grandeur and the ostentatious look of it. So I think skinny is the right word. Skinny is fit because the bodies have become skinny, the sizes have become skinny, the functions have reduced, so the shopping appetite has become skinny. So I feel there's a change in terms of, I don't know if this is right to put it this way, but there's more of quality versus quantity. They don't want like a set and a nut and a mang tikka and jhumkas and heart pulls. They're not going for that whole thing. They want to pick up one beautiful mang tikka with that one beautiful rani haar and they're done. So it's more like skinny yet classy. I think that's the transition that I'm seeing.
That's absolutely correct. And I totally agree to you. Skinny and classy is definitely in vogue. And I'm sure you're pretty much in lines with that right now. Great. All right. One last question for you. What should budding jewelry designers look out for, since the new normal has set in and is just not ready to go away? So a piece of advice from you.
A piece of advice to jewelry designers that are coming up. I feel that, you know, this is the new normal. Even though I kind of disagree, I don't think this is here to stay for very long. I think people are going to come back to their eventual routine, if sooner than later. But, you know, if we look at it in a larger scheme of things, our outings have been downsized. Our get-togethers have been, you know, restricted to a certain number. So the option, the occasion to wear jewelry has reduced. So I would suggest, you know, jewelry designers that are coming on board now to focus on jewelry that is more practical, more frequently usable and more everyday wearable. You know, so for example, I would love to wear a stud, you know, on to work or even around home or a small family gathering versus those investing your designs and ideas into those fancy, huge pieces, because where will you carry it? If I'm going for an intimate dinner to a friend's house, I'm not wearing those chunks.
Absolutely.
You know? So we're very one suggestion in short. I think I would be like, less is more. Focus on minimalist jewelry, more everyday jewelry, more practical jewelry, more versatile jewelry. You know, jewelry that can be worn with different things, and yet it's easier on the pocket and easier on yourself. Like more occasional.
Absolutely, like something like a detachable option, you know, you wear big on your big day and just like take small pieces out of it and use it in jewelry, like a regular work wear or, you know, to an occasion wear. Absolutely. That's perfect.
Absolutely.
That's great, Akanksha. So I think we have a question.
Sure.
We have a question from one of our viewer. Which course did you do from IGI?
I was a jewelry design graduate, and not many people know Natasha ma'am here was my teacher. So a lot of what I know is very much from her. So jewelry design graduate was what I did, yeah.
That's nice. So I hope that course was very informative for you and you learned a lot and you're using that information that you learned in your current field.
Absolutely. Like I said, before coming to IGI and attending those classes with you, I knew what jewelry is. I knew how to procure it and how to sell it. But what goes into making it, like from your head to your paper to a CAD file to, the transition of the nitty-gritties of how much metal needs to be put in, what stones need to be set in, whether prong setting is more appropriate or bezel is more appropriate, those were nitty-gritties that I could have either learned, how in India we say family business and you get used to it over a period of time. I feel that I kind of leaped ahead with that professional education. That helped me get a much better hold on what I'm doing much sooner. Yeah, that was definitely helpful.
Great, good to
Thank
hear.
you. Thank
You're welcome.
you.
So yes, that's very nice. Okay, thank you so much, Akansha. It was really nice that you could remove time for us and share your views to our viewers. Thank
It was
you.
a pleasure. Thank you for watching. Thank you for having me. Bye.
Thank you, everyone. All right, thank you.
Bye.